Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be get ready with me for Diwali video. If you wanna know how I achieved this look, then please keep on watching. Moving on to my eyes, I'm using the Prolonged Wear Concealer in NC45. I'm using this concealer because it doesn't crease and also my eyeshadows pop. Just blending it with my beauty sponge. And setting it with some loose powder. It's my all-time favorite Laura Mercier powder. And dusting off the excess powder. Now it's gonna be a simple eye look. I'm just gonna use three colors. Taking my Jaclyn Hill palette, taking the shade closest to my skin tone as my transition shade. Using a fluffy brush, just adding it to my adding it above the crease. Taking a smaller blending brush and taking the next darker shade to the shade which I used above the crease, just right in the socket of the eyes to create the shadow and deepen the crease. Taking a much smaller petite brush, I'm using a deeper shade than the shade which I used on the crease, exactly on the crease. If you can see, the dimensions are created with the eye. It's just the shadow basically, wherever the natural shadows are in my eye. Adding on the lighter shade just right above the all these to blend in the edges, and using a much thinner brush for my outer V, I'm taking the same exact darker shade which I used in my socket on my outer V. Using a clean blending brush, I'm just cleaning out the edges and making them look softer. Now, using my fingertips, taking a bronzy brown shade from the palette and applying it only to the 1/3 of my eyelid because I want to keep the outer corners matte. I actually wanted to add some glitter, but then this look turned out really well, like however it is. So I didn't want to add any more drama to it because this looked beautiful on its own. Just adding on some inner corner highlights using the light shade from the palette. Highlighting my brow bone using the same light shade which I used in the inner corners. Moving on to the face, the primer today I'm using the Benefit Pore Freshener Primer. It's a very good pore filling primer, but then don't use it on the whole face, it might clog your pores. I'm using it only on my T-zones because I want to keep it smooth. The rest of my face is fine. If you could see, immediately it took away all the shine from my face. And now for the foundation today, I'll be using... Okay. Before that, I'm color correcting using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Orange. I'm blending it using a brush. Because when I use a beauty blender, it takes away most of the products. So I don't, for the color correcting, using the brush is the best way. Just running over it with my beauty blender to take off excess product. And now for the foundation, I'm using the MAC Studio Fix Fluid in the shade NC45. I'm using a buffing brush, a kabuki brush to blend everything in and push the product in. I'm not dragging it because I want the orange character to stay in place underneath. If I drag with the foundation, it's gonna move away wherever I placed it from. So now after that is done, I'm taking my beauty blender and making everything smooth and evened out using the excess product on my neck, leftover foundation on my neck. For my concealer today, I'll be using the Maybelline Fit Me concealer in the shade 40 Caramel. It's a newer shade addition added in India, because only Cafe was available, Cafe and Deep was available before this, but then still they were really dark. Caramel is just right, perfect color. For my cream contour, I'm using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Espresso, applying on my jawline and my nose, underneath my chin. Just going over the concealer again to check if there's no creases or settles in the fine line. To set everything in place, I'm just adding my Laura Mercier powder mixed with my Sasha Buttercup yellow tint powder under the eyes and wherever I applied my concealer. I'm not gonna bake for a very long time because I want this look to stay luminous and dewy. So baking might take off all the luminosity from the foundation and the face. Just dusted off the excess powder which I applied, and to set the contour, I'm using the Too Faced bronzer in dark chocolate Soleil to bronze up the face and add some definition to wherever I apply the contour cream. I'm correcting my contour using the same powder just underneath the contour so that my contour line is prominent. Dusting off it immediately because, like I said, I want to keep this base luminous as possible. And here, this one's a hack, guys. I forgot the brow gel which I usually use in this video. So I use my mascara to add some color to the brows. This does the same job as the brow tint brow gel would do, but the shades are different. I use a brown shade usually for a brow gel, but this one was black. For my liner today, I'm using the NYX matte liner. This is light wing. This is a beautiful liner from NYX. It's just recently launched in India because the shiny glossy version was available then, but the matte one wasn't available. Now moving on to my lower eyes, I'm just adding the darkest shade which I use on the outer V with a petite brush and just applying it on the lower lashes and adding on some more inner corner highlight. For mascara, I'm using the Essence mascara, the same which I use for my brows as well. It's a waterproof mascara. I usually don't use waterproof mascaras because it's gonna be difficult to take it off. And also it's gonna harm my lashes. Since I'm not gonna add some falsies for this video, I'm gonna just load up some mascara, lots of mascara, even on the lower lashes. For my lips, I'm just taking the excess lip balm which I apply at the beginning of any makeup just to keep my lip hydrated. I'm just adding my PAC lip liner in the shade Infinite Kiss. And for the lipstick, I'm adding the Anastasia Beverly Hills lipstick, liquid lipstick in the shade Catherine. This lip looks bright at the first, but then as it dries down, the color tones down to a deeper shade. For my blush, I'm using the MAC blush in the shade Fever. This is my most favorite blush ever because it's so true to my skin tone. Like, it's just the perfect blush for my skin tone. And for my highlight today, I'll be using the MAC Skin Dimension in the shade Golden Ho Darling. Just just adding on some more highlight to the chin, cupid bows, and wherever I feel like the light hits up on my skin. That's all, guys. I added some sindoor, some bindi with my same liquid sindoor which I use for my forehead thing. And that's it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. If you liked it, please subscribe to my channel and leave your suggestion in the comment section below. Have a happy Diwali. Bye, guys.